What is difficult about doing gratitudes? Okay, what's difficult is that many times when we are in life, we just skim over the small things. So our brain gets used to just skimming over things, and that's when it starts to take things for granted. Okay? And so we have to have something really high emotion for us to start to feel grateful for it. So that's why gratitude sometimes can be hard, especially focusing on the small gratitudes, because we haven't been training our brain to do that. The other thing that's hard with gratitudes is that we get so worked up about what we are unhappy about and complaining and talking about it and saying, if I didn't have this, I would do this. If I didn't have this, it would be different. We actually never really think about how exactly it will be different. We just talk about, well, I can't do that because of this is happening or this exists. I just can't do it. But we actually never get beyond that and have our brain explore what it would be like if what we're saying was blocking us was gone. So with gratitudes, if you learn to really imagine what your life would be like if it was an emotional roller coaster, or if it was having issues with so and so, or if work was really great, or if there was no coronavirus, if you really, 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 really look at it and get some details on it and emotion with it, you gotta put the emotion is so critical. You gotta feel it and taste it. Some people say, well, that's kind of hard. Well, think of this way. When you think about your favorite meal or your favorite dessert, is it hard for you to imagine it, see it, and taste it? No. So that's because we've trained our brain to do that. So you can do that with this also. So you've got to feel it. When you do the combination of actually imagining and being able to see and also feeling it, it's very, very explosive in how way it will shift how you are feeling inside. I hope that helps. Ciao.